Hey, it's Tin La from DIY, and welcome to my channel. Today in this video, I'm gonna talk about TrueNAS CORE virtual machine installation on VMware ESXi 7.0. And make sure you watch to the end of this video because I will touch on some of the tips and tricks to make it work in virtualization environment. First, let's go download TrueNAS CORE ISO image file. Open up your browser and search for TrueNAS on Google. With a couple of clicks, you should be able to download TrueNAS CORE ISO file. Did I mention that TrueNAS is free? Yes, it is free. I know TrueNAS is still in beta stage, but the installation process should be the same with the released production version. Now, we can go ahead and review hardware requirement for TrueNAS system. First, 8 GB of RAM as a minimum. I'm going to give it 20 GB of RAM in virtual machine. Second, operating system should not be installed on USB device, but rather an SSD with a minimum of 16 GB of storage. Since it is a virtual machine, I'm going to create a 20 GB of storage space for TrueNAS using an SSD data store. Third, for storage disk, you should not be using the SMR technology. SMR stands for Single Magnetic Recording, which helps drive manufacturer to make a bigger hard drive without additional physical bladder. SMR is good for archiving purposes, but not for write and rewrite operation from NAS standpoint. Some of the Western Digital RAID drives are advertised as a NAS storage devices, but they are actually using the SMR technology, which is not healthy for your system later on. You want to make sure that you use CMR technology. CMR stands for Conventional Magnetic Recording. And from what I research and read online, all Seagate Iron Wolf product line use CMR technology. Last, you should be using Intel chipset for your network interface, since TrueNAS, which based on free BSD, doesn't have a good driver support for Realtek network adapter. So make sure you use Intel chipset for your network interface. Anyways, that's 4 things you need to know, and keep that in mind when using TrueNAS as in general. Okay, once the ISO file download completed, we are going to upload it onto VMware ESXi data store. Let's go ahead and open up our data store browser and hit upload button from the top left corner, and then select TrueNAS CORE ISO file that we downloaded earlier and hit open to upload. This can take a few minutes depending on your system and network. Once that's done, I'm going to go ahead and create a new virtual machine for TrueNAS. First, I'll give it a name and make sure that we select FreeBSD12 as a guest operating system version in this page. On select storage page, I'm going to select the correct SSD data store. On customize setting page, I'm going to give 6 vCPUs. You can give more or less depending on your needs. 20 GB of RAM and 20 GB of SSD storage disk for the NAS operating system using equally zero thick provisioning disk. It can take a while creating the disk with equally zero thick provisioning, but you get better performance on the first write operations. That's a trade-off between thick and thin provisioning. Performance-wise, they're pretty much the same on subsequent write and read operations. For network adapter, I select the correct port group for VMware ESXi virtual switch. After that, I select TrueNAS installation media ISO file that we have downloaded earlier for the CD and DVD drive to boot from. For hard disk controller, we make sure that we select the correct SATA or SAS hard disk controller, and then hit next to confirm our machine settings, and then finish to create our virtual machine for TrueNAS. Now you gotta wait for VMware to create a disk. It can take a while creating the disk. If you have a spinning disk, it can take really long time. So be patient here. If you don't wanna wait for disk creation, you can select thin provisioning, but then again, you will get a performance hit with the first write, which means that your TrueNAS installation will take a little bit longer. Your choice here. You can now double click to boot up and hit enter to confirm the boot from TrueNAS installer. At the console setup page, hit enter to install and then select 20 gigabyte of VMware virtual disk that we assigned for this machine earlier, and hit OK to continue and then yes to proceed with the installation. Give it a root password and remember this password so you can log in the GUI once the installation is finished. For boot mode, we select boot via BIOS. After about 5 minutes, the installation is finished and you will be able to log in the web interface with the root password that you created earlier and the IP address that you see on this console setup page. Open up your browser again and enter the IP address that you see on the console setup page to access the GUI. The installation of TrueNAS is now completed. You will have complete control of your NAS system through this web interface. As promised, I'm going to let you know my tips and tricks to make TrueNAS to work in the virtual machine environment. First and foremost, you need to make sure that your system has two separate disk controller units. One is used by VMware ESXis, where you make data stores out of them. And the other, which you enable pass-through for TrueNAS to utilize. If your system has only one hard disk controller unit, it's not going to work. And it's going to give you a lot of headaches later on. And in this case, you can always buy an additional host bus adapter for your stored disk, which you can find it on eBay or AliExpress for roughly about $50. This will enable TrueNAS to control more hard disks. And for your info, I just got myself a LSI HBA hard disk controller for 8 disks, right? I'll post a link if you don't know what I'm talking about in the description below. It is on transit right now from China. Second tip, from ESXi interface, you need to make sure that you assign and reserve all RAM for TrueNAS to utilize. Basically, you don't want ESXi swapping out memory with NAS operating system. It is bad for your NAS system. Speaking of RAM, ECC RAM is recommended. Another tip is don't use any plugins. I mean, use TrueNAS as what it is, a NAS system for storage. That's it. Don't run Plex Media Server on it. Don't run Nextcloud Server on it. Don't run any plugins, basically. Within ESXi, you can always spin up a Ubuntu Server virtual machine and use that to host your Plex Media Server and have it access to your NAS system. It's better that way. You don't want to bloat your NAS system with a lot of plugins. If you have a problem, it's really hard to indicate where the problem is. That's it. Those are my tips for TrueNAS to work in the VM environment. And this concludes my videos for TrueNAS virtual machine installation on the VMware ESXi 7.0. And I hope that you find this video is useful. And don't forget to leave any comment or questions about this video. Your input is appreciated. And also, if you want to see how I put together a home lab system using a dual core Intel Xeon E5 2667 V2 processor, which I benchmark against i9-9900K, you can see the result. I put it up there. You can now subscribe to my channel. I'm pretty sure that you get 10 years younger by doing that. No, I'm joking. Bye for now, and I'll see you next video.